I was just 3 years old when I was given this book. It's a baptism gift from my godfather, Charlie, and now it goes with me wherever I go. I don't think it's unusual to give an infant or a child or even an adult a Book of Common Prayer when they join the faith, but I do think that for many of us, it remains one of those beautiful leather-bound books that often gathers dust in a place of prominence on our bookshelf. Now, I might be wrong, but I feel like there's a belief out there that this book is made for priests. It's made for people who, like me, walk around in a collar and lead worship. But I wasn't a priest when I received this book. I wasn't a deacon. I wasn't a lay worship leader. I was three. This book wasn't given to me to make me a capable priest. It was given to me to make me a strong Christian in the Episcopal Church. The Book of Common Prayer isn't made for priests. It's made for people like you. It has so much to offer, from short services that can be done with the family to poetic prayers that can help us articulate what we cannot on our own. Now, it took me time to learn how to navigate this, to understand this, but luckily for you, sitting at your home, well, you've got time. So we're going to start learning from this great tradition and this book together.
Hey, Mom! So for the first prayer book lesson, Morris asked if I would talk about Compline.
Yeah.
So y'all know I was not raised in the Episcopal Church, and so the prayer book is not something that I grew up with, and that also includes Compline.
Mm-hmm.
And so my first introduction to Compline was at Camp Bratton Green. When Morris and I were in college, he spent a summer on permanent staff there. And so I went for a week to be a counselor during one of the Midler sessions. And we did Compline every night. And so that was my first experience with Compline, and honestly, with the prayer book in general. And so if you have a prayer book with you, feel free to open it up and just look with me. We're not going to go through this service, but I do want to point out to you where it is on page 127. If you don't have a prayer book at home, you also can just look it up online. There's a way to view all the services online, which is neat. Something else that when Morris was in seminary, we would get together. We lived in an apartment complex with a lot of other seminary families. And so some evenings, it didn't matter the weather, rain, shine, snow, it didn't matter. We would get together and huddle just in the courtyard and do Compline. Sometimes if it was really cold, we would go through the service as quickly as possible, just to kind of not to get it over with, but just to do that together, and then go back home to where it was warm. And then if it was a nice day, we would stay and linger and kind of sit in the prayers for a while, which was nice. But something that I like about Compline and just about the prayer book is that you can do it by yourself. And it's a nice way just to kind of close the day and to spend time in God's Word and to read through prayers that are written so eloquently and can express things that maybe you don't know how to say.
Just this short service, and I really do mean it, it's a short service, probably anywhere from 3 to 5 minutes. If you do it on your own, you can, of course, take longer. You get a lot of the same things that we see in our Sunday services. You get the prayers, you get the confession, you get psalms, and you get reading from Scripture. You get the repetition that I think we so often crave as worshipers in this Anglican tradition. And I think that if any of your kids have been to camp, they'll tell you how much this service has meant to them and to their formation. And I think that, especially in this time when we're not able to gather together, this is a great opportunity with your family to get together, to huddle like we did when we were back in seminary on those cold 20-degree nights. And to say the prayers, to be with one another, to be with God, and bask in this tradition of ours. Anyway, I hope you enjoy Compline.
Bye, Mom.